Hi everyone, hope you're okay. I'm going to do a kind of tutorial with my new makeup, well, I Love Makeup Revolution palette in Fast Love, the one I featured in my beauty haul video before last. So I said I'd try it out, and I have once already. If you follow me on Instagram, you'll have seen, hopefully I can recreate that look or similar to. Believe me, I'm no expert, definitely no expert. So this is much of an experiment for me. Is also a bit of fun. Hope you like it. I've already done, sorry if the camera's a bit wobbly, I'm balancing it on the table, if you can see me properly. I've already done a base, which is my usual. You've probably seen this before on the last one. Some Garnier BB cream. And then, before that, I always do that, the L'Oreal Skin Perfection Serum. I always put that on in the mornings before my base. Really like that one. And the Healthy Mix, Bourjois Healthy Mix Concealer in Light, I think that is. Yeah, oil free. Light is under my eyes, around the nose areas, and I've got a bit of redness on my chin. It's probably still a bit see-through with the BB cream, but I've been liking light coverage. I always do like light coverage. And then with some, take my sponge out, some, this I've hit pan, I really like Rimmel Compact, so I've got some of that over it. And also, some Rimmel Natural Bronze. This is really good, again, I've hit pan, but I don't want to waste it, so I'm using that up all over, really, because I think some of these ivory or light shades are quite a bit too light on me, but if I go the one darker, it's too dark, so I try and just put a bit of bronzer on, and then the eyes, the usual Revlon, put it the right way, Brow Fantasy in Brunette. I don't use the gel side, but I use a pencil. I think I need to get some new eyebrow stuff. So yeah, so let's get started. I've done all that. Start with the eyes, obviously. I've got three brushes with me. I need to get more eye brushes, and it also comes with little sponge applicators, which I wasn't going to use, but I am going to use now because I'm running out of things. So yes, so we'll start with a base shadow. So I'm going to use, don't want to blind you, take these sponge things out, because I'm using this big mirror. It's got such a lovely big mirror with it as well. Hopefully you can see this, it's a bit awkward. I'm going to use that cream one there just for an all over base. So hopefully this will be a bit of an experiment, trying to hold a mirror and do the makeup at the same time. Hope you can see this okay. If not, I'll have to do it all over again. So yeah, all over the eye. It's a nice cream, standard base. There we go. Yeah, this is all experimentational. Is that a word? For me. Trying to do eyeliner from that. Oh, I've stubbed the end of the purple one on there. Purple shade, never mind. So, see how it goes. Yep. Yeah. Bit more, I like quite bright, make a nice good base there under the brows. There we go, so that's your base, and I'm going to do a crease. I did a mixture of both of these colours last time, so I'm going to do, because these are all matte shade obviously at the top, I'm going to do the lighter one and then the darker brown. Again, I'm hoping you can see this okay. That one and then that one. Let's have a go there. This is more like a beigey. I'm no good at describing colours. So we'll put that in the crease. Again, I've got quite hooded eyes, so I feel like I have to go quite high up. Powder, it's quite a bit of loose powder off it, which I forget to blow off. I see it coming off. And then we'll go for the darker colour. These colours are very good bases, definitely like them. So, really hard to try and do my left eye and balance mirror at the same time. I'm hoping you can see this. Looking where I'm blending. Okay, so we've got a good base, a bit of a brownie crease in there, and then I'll start with the colours now. I did this, like I said, the other day, just as a practice and experiment, so I don't feel pressured by the camera, but I feel okay with it now, I'm really relaxed. But I fancy doing the pink, so I'll try recreate that look again. I started with quite a bright colour on the lid itself. Again, I'm just trying to hold this up. I'm going to use that one there. The nice bright pink one with my Barry M eyeshadow case that I got a while ago. Sorry if that's noisy. So yeah, I'm really liking all this makeup. I went Superdrug again yesterday and got other things, so I'm gonna film a haul after this. And I went the car boot on the Sunday, last Sunday, and I got some stuff from there because there's a really good stall there, and you got like all discontinued new brand names, so you'll see that I got some Rimmel and other things. Yeah, this is very 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 powdery but good. I'm not sure if I put this on with, I think I put this on with a sponge applicator last time. There we go. They're nice and pink. I think pinks do go with brown eyes. I'm sure they go with any colour eyes really, don't they? As long as it's... Yeah, pink's a nice colour anyway. I'm going to try these blues next time as well. Make sure that's quite caked in there. Oops, excuse me, that's my phone. Voicemail. Let's listen to that. For some reason, my phone's not ringing. It just tells me I've got a voicemail, somebody's rang me. I don't know why it's not working. So, yeah, I've got the light colour on the actual lids, and I'll use one of these sponge applicators for. I'll do the outer crease now. So, I've got all pink powder and the rest of the colours now. It's quite. Quite powdery there and loose. So we'll go with just the darker colour from that one next to it, which is that the shimmery pinky colour on the outer bit. I'll do this with the sponge, like I said, it's easier. That goes like that. I think I'm okay with the eyeshadow bit as such. I'm not very good at blending at all, but I'm okay with this side of it. It's just the I'm sure we'll be for a while practicing the eyeliner that goes with it. So I'm going to use a pencil one today, one I bought yesterday, which I've repurchased, one of my favourite ones that is like I've rediscovered it, which is the Bourjois Smoky Eyes one. There we go, so and try blend that in a little bit more. Oops, sorry, it's my phone again. So yeah, and then I'm gonna go for a darker colour. I found this really nice, really dark purple, again in the outer corner, just to emphasise the eyes a bit more. It's, oh gosh, gone in the blue. You want blue. So I think you put them, I'll put it in like a C shape bit. This is definitely not going to be perfect, but I'll give it a go. It's quite hard doing the left when you try to hold the mirror as well. So we went the seaside on Saturday. Oop. It's a bit of a mess. I'll go over it with the light one. Went the seaside on Saturday and I vlogged, and I kind of enjoyed it actually. It was alright vlogging. Just really, really still getting used to it. So But yeah, it was good. Go over that more with a bit of pink because I went over too much, I think. So yeah, I quite enjoyed it. And Gav's really, he's quite encouraging for me to do this because I feel like it's really good for my confidence. I feel so much more relaxed in front of the camera, and it sounds weird, but I feel like I can talk to people in person a bit more confidently. I did have confidence and then I lost it a bit, and then I think gradually it's coming back. I don't know if you can see that okay. I'm going to highlight above again with that same white coloured one. Just under the brow. I think this is looking okay. They're very pigmented. Yeah, I quite like the pink ones. So that's that. I can't shut that. I need the, can't open it again. Okay, so I'm just gonna grab the eyeliner that I bought. Smoky Eyes effect, really creamy. I think because I've got quite, I don't know if I've got loose skin on my eyelids, but this seems to suit it better because it's a bit more creamier. Or perhaps dry skin. And with it being new, it's quite sharp as well, which is good. Yeah. Hard to talk and do eyeliner at the same time. Have you seen this okay? So I think for the money, this palette was, what, $7.99? Brilliant for that. Definitely really good. Let's do, I'm doing the mouth thing. Open the mouth when you're doing it. So that's that. You can, you've got a little brush on the end of this so you can actually smudge. Stick that brush, smudge the yeah, it's quite nice smudged actually. Smudge the eyeliner out, makes it a softer line. I do like the clean black line of the liquid liner though, that's good. I'm gonna have to try to do this in the mirror now. With it holding the mirror even. Do it with my left hand. If you guys can see this. Just basic eyeliner. Really not feel confident enough to do the winged eyeliner on camera yet. What more practices and I've got time. Everything's on a list and you haven't got time into. There we go. I feel like I'm kind of rushing this as well because I'm expecting Gav back from the dentist anytime soon. He's, what time is it? Yeah. Should be having his tooth out round about now, I think. So I'll wait for Gav to come back. We'll just smudge it in again. Yeah, I've already got a brown one in this collar and it's really nice. I haven't used it for years and I forgot how nice it was. There we go, that's that. Let's put the ends back on that. See that okay? So, I'll perhaps put a bit of highlighter on the inside of the eye actually. I'm going to use this the pink a bit lower down, the sparkly one there. I really need some more brushes if I'm going to do multiple eyeshadows into. So let's put that in the corner. I don't know if you can see that okay. Nice and sparkly. Definitely got glitter in it, I think that. And then I've got a MAC 266. I think it's an eyeliner brush, or you can use it for your eyebrows. I got this years ago. Again, I've never bothered with it, but I realise now how useful and good these, well, the MAC products are, and the MAC brushes. So I'm going to use that under the lid. So it's one of the cats on the outside. Use that under the lid there. Going to use a bit of that purple again. put under there, under there, under the eyeshadow. I perhaps should have done this before the eyeliner, but hey ho. Again, like I said, I'm not very good at doing things in particular order. That looks alright. Let's put around on there too. I think sometimes, as they say, less is more. And then I get carried away because I'm liking the product. Good brush though, I'm liking this brush. If that makes it look alright, so a bit too much, let me know what you think. Okay, so keep closing this mirror. And let me know if this is a better than the other tutorial I did, because in fact, because I'm holding a mirror, it's perhaps closer for you guys to see. So yeah, just the usual lash curlers. I've had these years again. I've heard that you can heat them up and it's supposed to kill your eyelashes better. I don't know. So I'm using the Laura Mercer sample eyeshadow I've got. It's in just long lash. And this is just black colour. I don't know where I've put my Benefit one, to be honest. But I really like this one. I've featured this again on Pinterest. I like the brush, I think. It really separates your lashes. There you go, that's that one. I'm really sorry if it's noisy, I keep pressing this down. There we go, that side. Actually, I'm really liking these colours. I'm not sure where I sit first, but there we go. Obviously, mascara even makes a look, doesn't it? There we go. And I've still got to do, blusher and a bit of highlighter. I've already bronzed a layer with the Rimmel. I've got this Sleek palette, face form, contouring and blush palette. I think these are quite popular. It's a bit dusty, I'm afraid, but this is in the fair colour. I'm going to use it's quite a glittery blusher. It's not my favourite, but it's okay. And the highlighter just above it. Again, this has got a nice mirror, but it's very dusty, so using my Real Techniques contour brush. Everybody's got these, haven't they? So, see a bit of blusher. It doesn't show up actually, it's the Fair Sleek Contour Kit Face Warm. I don't feel like the blush is that pigmented. You have to build it up, but I don't know if it's because I've got a bit open pores, but it makes, it's not, like I said, the best blusher, but it's okay because it's all in one kit. And then I'll use the highlighter. On the sides there, on top of the cheekbones. I've already highlighted the top of my brow, so I don't know, a bit on the nose, I suppose. There it works. I don't know if you can see that, but it's on. That's that. And lastly, I'm gonna do some lipstick. I thought to go the old faithful Rimmel, just bitten lip stain in Love Sick. You've seen this one before. Again, I haven't got many lipsticks, so I'm still building up a collection. Well, collection on everything, really. There you go. Quite bright for that, isn't it? And a bit of lip gloss, Pink Lip Gloss, Model & Co. Which is Fairy Floss to go over the top. Just make it look a bit shiny. I figured this with being a light pink, it'll look good. Just in the Cupid's bow in the middle bit. So yeah, there's my finished look. Let's pull this clip off. This time I won't make my hair all fluffy, hopefully. I'm actually wearing my hair down today, which is unusual. I've got quite a bit of bronze on to the end. So yeah, there's the finished look of the Isle of Makeup Fast Love palette. Yeah, I'm really liking the colours on this. Value for money. I do recommend it, and I'll probably try a Natural Eyes palette of the Makeup Revolution, and even perhaps a brighter one. But the colours, I think, are really good and shine out, and the pinks on this are really pretty. I hope you liked it. I'm going to film now, hopefully, a makeup haul. From what, like I said, I did earlier at the car boot, and then yesterday I went super drunk as well. So yeah, hope you like it. Any suggestions, if you think I need to add something in, or you want to see another look, then let me know in the comments below. Give it a big thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe and have a look at my blog as well. I'm going to do a more detailed post, I think, of this palette as well. Well, thanks for watching, guys. Bye.